lane confusion. Too many old and new lane markings are on the freeway in Windsor Heights. KCCI's Todd Magel is there live to explain the problem and the solution.
Steve, we are along 235 near 63rd Street, and the problem began right here behind me on the interstate. Construction crews had to move some lanes for a new building project, and that's when the problem started.
At first glance, traffic moves along just fine on I-235 in Windsor Heights, but take a closer look. Next to the newly painted white lines, the remains of the old scraped off lines. And it's these darker markings that seem to be causing some trouble.
I seldom take that exit, but on the times that I have, it's been a little bit of confusion.
The lines are changed. You can see they're obviously changed, but the old lines are still sitting there, so it is a little confusing.
The DOT has taken some complaints. During certain times of the day, the light hits the old gray scraped lines. Some drivers can't detect the correct lane to use.
It just appears that it's the sun kind of glares off of that.
The DOT says they had to shift traffic away from a construction crew installing new sign trusses over the freeway. Drivers will be happy to know workers will now come in and cover up the tangle of old and new lane markings.
From 63rd to 73rd, we are going to put a new surface course down on the roadway, which will provide new lines and will get rid of all the ghost lines in the westbound directions.
That should happen in the next few weeks, so until then, drive carefully.
And keep in mind, the plan all along was once the construction was finished, they were going to cover up all these white and dark lines. But a lot of people, Steve, didn't really know that was part of the plan. Keep in mind, it's just the westbound lanes that they're going to recover with asphalt and new white lines. The eastbound lanes are going to leave for now because they don't think that is quite as bad.
All right, Todd Magel, live along I-235 in Windsor Heights. Thank you, Todd.